When you're planning a food photo, the camera angle you shoot with is just as important as everything else in your scene. So knowing how to choose the right angle for the subject can help you create a more powerful image. So if you want to stop guessing which angle is best for your food photo and start making more informed composition decisions, then this video is for you. Choosing the right angle for an image is subjective, but there's really more science behind all this stuff than you might think. What really helped me transform my food photography was starting to plan out my pictures before I started my photo shoot. This helped me think through the composition and the camera angle so I wasn't ad-libbing on the fly. Planning your pictures on paper before you start doesn't mean shutting off your creativity or not going with the flow in the moment. It just means understanding and using this information to help you be more creative effectively. So before you go any further, download and print off your free photo composition kit and let's jump right in and start looking at the three main camera angles for your food photography. The straight-on angle is great for subjects like burgers, sandwiches, pancake stacks, etc., or any food where there's more detail on the side or the inside than the top. It's an angle that also allows you to utilize the background and to add additional props and objects, which can be useful to build out your food story. In this shot of these pancakes, I used a straight-on angle plus a long focal length lens to make the stack look really heroic and powerful and avoid any distortion. I also wanted that honey swirl action to be the focal point of the image, and the straight-on angle worked best to highlight that. Do remember that the focal length of the lens you're shooting with will have an impact on the general look and feel of your photo. My favorite way to take straight-on shots is with a focal length anything from 60 millimeters upwards, but normally I use my 90 millimeter macro lens. If you use too wide angled of a lens for these shots, you're gonna end up with some weirdly stretched lines because of your wider field of view. If you wanna learn more about the best lenses for food photography, then check out this video I made a while ago all about that. I like to think of the 25 to 75 degree range as a fluid angle. It's basically everything in between the straight on shot and the flat lay, which we're going to come to in a minute. It's hard to know at exactly which point your photo will look best in this range, as it does depend on how much detail there is on top of your subject. Typically, a good starting point is to shoot flatter subjects somewhere between 90 degrees and 45 degrees, and taller subjects more from straight on to 45 degrees. I shot these little chocolate cakes at about 45 degrees, again with a long focal length lens. They aren't super tall, but most of the detail is going on in the top with the toasted hazelnuts and that little drip down the side. So a straight on shot would have missed a lot of that detail on the top, but a flat lay would have also missed the texture on the sides and potentially hidden the overall shape of the cakes. So by combining this 45 degree angle with some side backlight, I was able to capture a really nice specular highlight on the ganache and that little motion of the drip. I mean, who doesn't love a good ganache drip in a food photo? So let's take a look at another example here, this time with a 75 degree angle. This angle is just a little bit down from a flat lay, so you largely get an overhead view, but you do still get just a little bit of side view as well. In this drinks image, the 75 degree angle allows you to mostly focus on the decoration on the top, but still see the shape of the glass rather than just floating circles. This angle is really effective for drinks where you still want some depth, but you don't have any layers or particular interest to highlight on the side of the glass. The focal length of the lens you use is also flexible on this shot, depending on the look you're going for. For the drinks photo, I used a 35 millimeter lens on a full frame camera, which gives some perspective distortion, making the picture look like it's bulging outwards a little bit. This isn't something you always want in a photo, and it doesn't work particularly well for straight on shots, but for this kind of image, I think it works and can be quite effective. As I said before, all of these things are subjective and it's fun to play around and find the style you like. The flat lay is probably the most flexible angle in food photography and definitely one of the most popular. You only need to scroll through Instagram for about 5 seconds to realize that food photography is all about the flat lays. For me, me, it's one of the best storytelling angles, although you can of course tell your food story at any angle. It's perfect for dishes where all the detail is on top, like this noodle soup, or where you want to show a full table scene. In terms of lens, again, it depends on the look you're going for. A wider angle lens with a more narrow aperture, somewhere kind of f4 upwards, can be useful for capturing really wide scenes. But if you're going for a detail-orientated close-up from top down, you might want to consider using your long focal length macro lens and just hoisting up really high on your tripod or C-stand. Okay, so now we've talked about which angles work great in food photography, let's take a quick look at which angles to avoid. Keep your horizons straight. Those diagonal shots and Dutch angles might work well in selfies, but if your food looks like it's about to slide right off the photo, your viewer will probably want to tilt their head to look at the photo. So if you find yourself kind of doing this while you're looking at it, straighten it up. Okay, so this one isn't technically a camera angle, but I do think it fits in here quite nicely. There's nothing wrong with a close-up of your food or even a nice macro shot of some berries or detail. But if you're so close to your subject that the viewer will have to kind of guess what it is, probably need to pull back a bit. Again, not strictly an angle in itself, but more about how to use the right angles for the lens you're using. For more information on the best camera lenses for certain food photography and camera angles, check out my other video all about lenses. When you're planning your food photos and thinking about what angles you're going to use, you should ask yourself these questions. One, what am I shooting? And two, how am I styling it? The answer to the first question will sometimes tell you the angles you should be using, as certain foods lend themselves much better to a particular angle than another. The classic burger shot from straight on will allow you to see all the different layers inside your burger, and a pizza will look great from top down where you can really see all the toppings. But what about foods that don't have an obvious most flattering angle? Well, this is where the answer to your second question becomes really important. Let's take something liquid as an example. The best angle will really depend on how you're styling the shot. So for example, if you have soup in an opaque bowl with lots of detail on top, then a flatlay or a 75 to 45 degree angle is probably going to work best. But if you're layering something like overnight oats or a smoothie in a tall glass, then maybe a 45 degree angle to straight on would work better. You guys know how much of a fan of a tripod I am. I could literally sing until the cows come home about the benefits of shooting food with a tripod, but it can be super useful to explore your subject freehand first to help you find the best angle. Sometimes it can surprise you what your favorite angle can end up being, so do take a little bit of extra time for this exploration first. So that is it for today's video. I hope you got some useful tips about finding the best angle in your food photography. Don't forget to download my free composition kit, subscribe if you want to see more videos about food photography, and I will see you in the next one.
This battery's still going somehow.